Ladies and gentlemen, we are proud to bring you tonight a Dance Music Hall of Fame All-Star Band featuring Ray Chu. Be wrong. Oh,
you can't tell. Mix a special brew, put fire inside of you. Anytime you feel danger or fear, it's in me. I'm a Medea, cause I'm every woman. It's all in me. Anything you want done, baby, I do it naturally. Woo.
To the 2005 Dance Music Hall of Fame Awards. Now, here's the host of your show, the master of ceremonies, the legendary member of the Broadcast Hall of Fame, the Radio Hall of Fame, the Cable and Broadcast Hall of Fame, the NAB Hall of Fame, your very own Cousin Brucie!
I say good evening to you. Let me hear, let me see if there's anybody there I can't see. Good evening, cousins. Okay. I've been a very lucky man. Hold on to the teleprompter for a moment. By the way, these are not teleprompters. This is, I do a lot of spinning when I speak, and that's to protect the people in the expensive seats. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm a very lucky guy. I've been nominated and inducted into almost every Hall of Fame in my profession, so I figured I'd try for this one tonight. Didn't happen because I realized there's something that you guys have that I might not have, something called talent, which I just heard up on that stage. That is amazing. Welcome. Welcome. Woo! Welcome to the second annual Dance Music Hall of Fame, everybody, this induction and ceremony award show. How about a nice round of applause, first of all, to my cousin, Joey. Joey Carvello happens to be Billboard's 1978 DJ of the Year for that serious spinning during the cocktail party. Can I say that? And to one of the best I've ever heard in my life, and let me tell you, I've heard them all, Ray Chu of the Dance Music Hall of Fame All-Star Band. I'm really honored to be here tonight. I have always loved dance music, and so those of you who have listened to Cousin Brucie's shows on radio, on CBS, before they decided to sink their ship, and are now, of course, on Sirius Satellite Radio and on PBS. By the way, one of the most awarding shows we've ever had, the biggest money-making show for PBS, was the one of the last ones we did, I hope you saw it, the disco show, which came out of Asbury Park, which a lot of the people in the room, it was the biggest money-maker, which should tell you and people all over the nation what is going on. Because the Dance Music Hall of Fame was created to honor the pioneers of the dance and the DJ world. It was spawned in the 1970s. Dance music has become a global phenomenon, and Cousins dance music has fueled a multi-billion dollar industry encompassing nightclubs, DJs, remixers, producers, music companies, studios, dancers, performing artists, and much, much more. There are literally hundreds to thousands of DJs in virtually every city and nation in the world. Dance DJs have always been first, I hate to admit it, but it's true, to create new musical trends, and were the very first to expose hip-hop. Yes, yet in America, dance music remains largely unrecognized, which is ridiculous, for its impact and contributions. The Dance Music Hall of Fame has been born to give dance music and DJs their righteous place along with every other musical genre that we know. And because of this award show is just one of the events of the Dance Music Hall of Fame. And we plan a series of events, fundraisers throughout the year to raise awareness of the public and the stature of dance music. Now, many of Dance Music Hall of Fame board members are in the audience tonight, and if you would bear this with me, I'd like to briefly acknowledge those present because this is very important for their vision and their hard work to make this dream a reality. So my cousins, when your name is called, I'd like you to stand up, remain standing, and please, everybody, hold on to your applause because I know emotionally you're ready to let loose. I know that. Emotionally, I'm talking about now. Founding directors, will John Parker and Tom Silverman please stand up? I'm glad you're holding on to your applause. That's nice. Eddie O'Loughlin, the honorable and very talented and handsome Daniel Glass. Good, hold on to your applause, that's nice. Executive Director Catherine Laporte. And here's your advisory board, my friends. Brad LeBeau, Carrie Vance, Chris Cox, my cousin Dan Miller, everybody standing. Dane Hall, Danny Tenaglia, Frankie Knuckles. I love that name. Cousin Frankie Knuckles and Frank Murray, Hosh Gorelli, Inicia Sanchez, Primo Issy, and Jim Robinson, and my friend Joey Carvello, who's one of the best DJs I've ever heard in my life, Johnny Luongo, and the beautiful Judy Weinstein, Jürgen Kordulesch, Jürgen, Mel Cheren, and Michael Ellis, and Michael Pioletta, and Tony Monte. Stand up, Vince Pellegrino. Now, let's hear it. Come on. Nice. Okay, gentlemen, they know where you are. Ladies, they know where you are. So if anybody has anything that they're not happy with, grab one of those guys that just stood up. That's why I had him stand up. I'm getting tired of getting hit. After carefully considering all those who have made such an impact on your dance music and our dance music, our board first nominated potential nominees selected from thousands who made their first contributions at least 25 years ago, which is terrific. This is the way to do it. Let's never, ever forget the music. And this is the foundation. This is what counts. Let's never forget it, ever. And then a voting panel of over 1,000 dance music professionals all over the world voted for the final winners. Now, cousins, we appreciate your feedback and suggestions and hope that you'll offer more for future years on the website. And their website is dmhof.com. So you get on that and have some suggestions, we got it. Now, I'll tell you the reason I'm really here today, besides to honor some people that I admire, besides this man over here, who's magnificent, by the way. A portion of our proceeds will go to benefit Lifebeat. Give yourself a round of applause for what you're doing. When they called your cousin Brucie, I was riding very high off my Sirius satellite radio, thank God, today. Happiest I've ever been in my career, by the way. Lifebeat, as you know, is dedicated to reaching America's young, the youth, with a message of HIV/AIDS prevention. And I got to tell you something, unless we do this, unless we are the ones that do this, we are in deep trouble because the government's not helping us. Nobody's helping us. It has to come from here, the grassroots. And music be the food of love, William Shakespeare. This is where it starts. So cousins, Lifebeat, thank you. Lifebeat mobilizes the talents, thank you, and resources, and I mean that, of the music industry to raise awareness, provide support to the AIDS community. Oh, and listen. Here's something important. Please do not forget the silent auction. It's here in the room somewhere. I think it's right there, or maybe that's the food. And it's open for another, about to 10 o'clock, another 50 minutes. So bid and do yourself a favor because this is charitable and it is tax deductible. Bid and bid high if you want one of these items. We're offering great remixes and DJ gigs and more, all for a great cause. Gee, I wish they would have asked me. I would have loved to invite some winner up to watch us broadcast at Sirius Satellite Radio. It's really quite something to see. And now, back to this band. And we got a very special, special guest. Now, it's very special, this next woman is very special not only to you and to the public all over the entire world, because that's how far-reaching she goes. But I was very, very happy about one thing. I can take credit for being the very first person to play her first record on the radio. So she's very special to me, and we've been friends ever since. The surprise will be coming out, and you will know it. Ladies and gentlemen, let's rock and roll. Let's dance to the music.
I grew strong and I learned how to get along. So now you're back from outer space. I just walked in to find you here with that sad look upon your face. I should have changed that stupid lock. I should have made you leave your key. If I'd have known for just 1 second, you'd be back to bother me. Gone now, go. Walk out the door. Just turn around now. You're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who tried to hurt me? Sorry for myself, I used to cry. But now I hold my head up high and you see me. Somebody new. I'm not that chained up little person, still in love with you. And so you felt like dropping in and just expect me to be free. Now I'm saving all my loving for someone who's loving me. Go on now, go. Walk out the door. I've got all my life to live, and I've got all you did me wrong, and I grew strong, and I learned how to get along. So now you're back from outer space. I just walked in to find you here with that sad look upon your face. I should have changed that stupid lock. I should have made you leave your key. If I'd have known for just 1 second, you'd be back to bother me. Go on now, go. Walk out the door and just turn around now, 'cause you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who tried to crush me with goodbye? Well, you just got crumbled. Did you think I'd lay down and die? Oh, no, 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 not her. I will survive. And as long as I know how to love, I know I'm still alive. I've got all my life to live, and I've got all my love to give, and I'll survive. Gentlemen, the lovely Miss Allison Williams.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Gloria Gaynor.
A little bit, just a little bit. Go on now, go. Walk out the door and just turn around now, 'cause you're not welcome anymore.
Weren't you the one who tried to hurt me with goodbye? Did you think I crumble? Did you think I lay down and die?
Oh, no, no, no. I will survive. Oh, as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive. I've got all my life to live, and I've got all my love to give, and I'll survive. I will survive. We will survive.
Thank you.
All right, listen. How do you follow something like that? Well, wait till you see what's gonna happen. Ray, you better catch your breath in that one. I mean, is this a band? Ray Chew and the great sounds, everybody. Ray, that's great. Woo! I told you there'd be some surprises. Gloria, Gaynor and Williams. I mean, wow, that's Olympic stuff. Cousins, the Dance Music Hall of Fame is the only hall that honors records as well as people. And that's very important because without records, there would be no DJs. What a disgusting thought. What the hell would I do for a job? And whether it is vinyl or CD or data file, there's one thing it'll always be to us. We'll always call it a record. No matter where we are, it is a record. Anytime your cousin Brucie goes out to talk to kids anywhere in the nation, I talk about records, and they look at me, and they don't understand what I'm talking about, but they get the feeling. I want you to watch the video screens right now. They're all right over here, right? For the first of five records to be inducted tonight.
You say the word disco to most people, this is the image that appears in their head. The music, Stayin' Alive. The defining song of the disco era from Saturday Night Fever, the best-selling soundtrack of all time. Stayin' Alive took pop superstars the Bee Gees to an even higher level. Please welcome Stayin' Alive into the Dance Music Hall of Fame.
Wait, we're just getting warmed up, everybody. Is everybody happy so far? This is the beginning. Listen, as you know, this is the second annual event. This is going to grow, and I'm telling you, I'm making a prediction. I've been doing this a long time. This has more spirit, more electricity and energy than any Hall of Fame I've ever been involved with. This is terrific. You got the music. You got the soul and the spirit. Please welcome producer, arranger, writer and engineer. This guy does it all, whose work includes Black Ivory, Indie, Bumblebee, Unlimited Musique, Freak, Inner Life, Universal Robot Band, Sister Sledge, and more. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the best, Patrick Adams.
Born in France, Francois Kevorkian moved to New York when he was 21 years old. He began DJing in underground clubs in 1976 and soon became the DJ at New York Super Club, New York, New York. He then landed an A&R job at Prelude Records, where he began remixing super hits like Push, Push in the Bush by Musique, and D-Train's You're the One, Yazoo Situation, Go Bang by Dinosaur L, and many more. He has DJed at Paradise's Garage, The Loft, Better Days, Studio 54, Buttermilk Bottom, Club Zanzibar, and Les Mouches. And more recently, he plays his signature sound of soulful jazzy house worldwide. The architect of Body and Soul, Francois, runs his own label, Wave. And his studio axis is known worldwide. No one has ever been inducted for both DJ and remixer in the same year. And it will be a feat that will prove hard to top. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me give a double welcome to Francois Kevorkian as he joins the Dance Music Hall of Fame.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, everybody, for having me here tonight. It's kind of an interesting 30 years that it's been for me since I first came to the United States. And there's really been a lot going on in this town, a lot of very unforgettable moments, a lot of incredible people. And I don't know where to begin to say how much I appreciate all that I've learned, all that I've been taught here. There's certainly a number of very notable people I'm sure I'm going to forget, so I apologize in advance for that. But as Patrick mentioned, I did get hired by Prelude Records, head Marvin Schlachter, who I'd like to very much thank for giving me the opportunity to even go into the studio when he basically just hired me pretty much off the street, if you want to believe that, but it was true. And as well, I'd like to point out that there were many people that were instrumental in giving me the opportunity to do all the remixes and all the production work that I was asked to do, such as Chris Blackwell for Island Records, Seymour Stein for Sire, Daniel Miller for Mute Records, and many more along the way. And I have to thank all of them for letting me have some kind of shot at going in the studio when I really didn't know much. As far as all the producers that I've worked with over the years, of course, the first time I went in the studio was with Patrick Adams, so I really have to be more than thankful for him having sort of had one of those first influences on me, as well as Hubert Eves, who did D-Train. Hubert is with us tonight. And I'd like to also mention Bert Reed, from Crown Heights Affair. Sadly, Bert passed away this year. Bert produced Unlimited Touch and many other things for Prelude, which I think were really fantastic. As well, I'd like to certainly thank Ralph Hooter and Florian Schneider from Kraftwerk for hiring me in what started a lifelong friendship working together, as well as Alex Sadkin, who used to produce Duran Duran and many Grace Jones records before he passed away. And also acknowledge as inspiration people like Jimi Hendrix, Miles Davis, King Tubby, and John Coltrane as those who really helped me forge my musical taste. But beyond that, I think that it's really important to acknowledge the vast and incredible contributions that all the people who are working in the recording studios have made. Without them, it really wouldn't be possible for somebody like me to just walk off the street and learn remixing and put up a record that you guys listen to or that everyone thinks is outstanding. And as such, I think that it would be really important to acknowledge the contributions of people, like in my case, John Potoker, with whom I did many, many incredible mixes, like the D-Train remixes or Yazoo, as well as Michael Hutchinson, as well as J. Mark and all the rest of the team at Sigma Sound Studios, both in New York and Philadelphia. I'd like to also acknowledge Bob Blank for Blank Tape Studios, who turned it out day after day. Paul Groucho Smichael in England, Ron St. Germain here back in New York, and all the studios that we worked out that were absolutely fantastic, like Right Track Recording with Frank Filippetti and so on. And last but not least, I also would like to mention that our records don't really sound as good as they do without a helping hand from the mastering guys. And in my case, there was one person, there just was one, who really was above the fray. And his name is Herb Powers Jr. Thank you, Herbie. Herbie's mastered all the best records in the world. And we started kind of together. And I think that without all those people, I really don't feel I would have been able to do anything near what I did. And you know, the same, I'd like to extend some thanks to some of my employees and people at Access Studios, in particular Alan Friedman, who's here tonight, who's greatly helped me throughout the years, and all the other people that I've worked with, and also give some thanks to my family, my wife Tomoko, my son Yuzo, and my dad Pierre. So thank you very much. Wait. I'm sorry. Guys, hold it. I'm sorry, I forgot one award. Sorry about that. You're gonna have to hear a little more. I think I completely missed out on a whole bunch of things here. Anyway, since you like the first part so much, here's the remix. So for the dub mix, I figured we'd talk a little more about the acknowledgments of being one of the DJs that were selected into the Dance Music Hall of Fame. I wish to first and foremost tell everyone here how much I appreciate this honor. I'm literally not feeling very worthy of it. I could think of 100 other people who I think are incredibly, immensely talented. But that being the case, you guys chose to give it to me. So I think I need to give some more acknowledgments of people who I felt were not only extremely important, but crucial in the way I managed to do things. First, I'd like to mention that I came here as a foreigner 30 years ago, and that there's undoubtedly an amazing welcome, an amazing reception, and sort of a warmth, family-like atmosphere in all aspects of life, and especially when DJing. And I have to say, without question, that this came from the welcoming that I got from the African-American and Latino community in New York. They were absolutely amazing. I mean, those were really my teachers, they were really my peers, the people who helped me in every step of the way. I'd like to mention, of course, the first person who gave me a break, George Freeman, who ended up getting me to play the drums along Walter Gibbons at Galaxy 21, and from there, I worked in some other clubs, and of course, I'd like to acknowledge John Jellybean Benitez, Jellybean, who gave me my first DJ gig. So, Jellybean, thank you very much for, in fact, calling in sick that day. I will remember it forever. And as well, I'd like to very much extend my thanks to Hall of Fame inductee David Mancuso from The Loft. As well, I'd like to extend my thanks to Larry Levan, another Hall of Fame inductee, and T. Scott, and another person who also I think should be in the Hall of Fame called Walter Gibbons, who was so inspiring and so far ahead of his time. And I also would like to mention someone who inspired me greatly. His name was Grandmaster Flowers, Cameron Flowers from Brooklyn, one of the early mobile DJs. He was a genius, this guy. As well as Joey Bonfiglio and other people, such as people that I've worked with recently as a DJ, Rob Spurdy, Francesca Nessi, all the people at Sonar Music, Angels of Love in Napoli, Club Yellow in Tokyo, Satoru Ongawa in Precious Hall in Hokkaido, and all the other places overseas that I've been playing at. As well, I'd like to give a very, very special mention, dear in my heart, to Joaquin Yo Closel, Danny Krivet, Body and Soul. These guys are absolutely incredible. I'd like to mention Jeff Mills, the Wizard, and Derek May, the Innovator from Detroit, as being certain people that I really enjoy playing with. Larry Patterson, as an inspiration, Judy Weinstein, and for the record, I'd like to mention some people that work for me right now, like Aurelie Brambilla, and as well as Jody Blay, Erica Rubin from Deep Space, and give some many, many thanks to all the people who have waited patiently with me over the years for what is one has to be one of the most incredibly difficult jobs. So, I would like to say thank you very much to my wife Tomoko and son Yuzo, and have a great party, you guys. This is amazing.
Thank you. When I saw his name, on the roster of being inducted, I couldn't imagine what they wanted Dr. Kevorkian up here for, so it got me a little scared. I had no idea what a man that is. Listen, we can almost all go home. He mentioned everybody in the goddamn room. It's amazing. Breakfast will be served on me. No more. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, if you please, watch the video screens.
The winner of hundreds of awards, Quincy Jones has had his share of accolades. But tonight, we celebrate him for his impact on dance music. His own dance hits, such as I Know Corita, show his merit as an artist. His productions with Chaka Khan, Brothers Johnson, and the 1979 breakthrough album Off the Wall for Michael Jackson. Quincy's production of Thriller in 1982 for Michael Jackson proved to be his pinnacle in dance music, as the album went on to become the best-selling record of all time. Tonight, we induct Quincy into the Dance Music Hall of Fame.
And a big congratulations. And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, let's now welcome back, just back from Fire Island, this guy is hot, 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 the original macho man from the Village People, my cousin Randy Jones.
Well, how the hell is everybody out there tonight? Cuz was just joking with y'all. I was not really on no Fire Island. I was out on the West Coast doing a TV show. What a great joy it is to see these faces out here tonight. God bless us all. Let's give us all a big hand for still standing. Yeah. At first, I was afraid. I was petrified. Every single one of you sitting out there know those words and that feeling. I Will Survive is one of the most played records in history of dance music, right? It won the first disco Grammy in 1980, and it's been recorded in over 20 different languages worldwide. I gotta say, even the women's self-empowerment theme song, I Will Survive, has been used in many movies, and it still gets played at most bar mitzvahs and weddings. And trust me, I know a hell of a lot about bar mitzvahs and weddings. Ironically, I Will Survive was supposed to be the B-side for another song called Substitute, as we remember those of us from back then, but DJs were forced to flip it over, and they made the label take it to radio, and God, aren't we glad that you did. This lady that we're going to bring out to you right now is a beautiful human being that I can personally testify to, that I have shared the stages with, just speaking with her, we were reminiscing, from Madrid to Las Vegas to the Greek Theater in Los Angeles, here in New York, South America. We have played everywhere an act can play, and we've been there together or cross paths at one time or another. To accept the award for I Will Survive, let's hear it for the glorious, God-given Miss Gloria Gaynor!
Thank you. Thank you so much. It is such a great honor for me to be here among my peers, having been selected by my peers to receive such a wonderful award.
I forgot something. Thank you.
And it is beautiful. Thank you. As I was saying, I'm just really honored to be here and to be among so many great artists receiving this award, to have been chosen to receive this honor. I want to say that I have been supported by so many great people in achieving this and coming to this point in my career. I want to thank my producers, Dino Ficaris and Freddie Perrin, who has unfortunately passed away recently, but they were very, very wonderful producers, and Dino Ficaris drove me crazy being such a perfectionist in the studio, but he also spurred me on and drove me to the top of the charts, so I want to thank him. And all of the people from the record company, I want to thank tonight my lawyer who made sure I get paid. He is Ron Creedman, and he's sitting over here at my table. Thank you, Ron. He supported me all of these years. He's still with me more than 30 years. We've been together, and it's been wonderful. thank you so much, all of you, for your support. It was not about this song, but I have to say, because this is the Dance Music Hall of Fame, I have to thank, in front of all of you, I have to thank Brucie for being the first one to play my record, making it the first disco record ever to be played on AM radio. That was Never Can Say Goodbye.
She will always be my disco diva, no matter where I go, what I do. That's my disco diva. It was kind of interesting in those days. I had to fight pretty hard to get away from my Fats Domino and Everly Brothers and Drifters Records. And when this record came in, they told me I was crazy. And I said, I'll tell you what, you can have my contract back if it doesn't make it. They had to double my salary very quickly. Boy, she is hot stuff, right? So congratulations, Cousin Gloria. Ladies and gentlemen, watch now as Chic singer Silver Logan Sharp pays homage and tribute to Chic and the music of my cousin Nile Rodgers, and the late, great Bernard Edwards. Please.
Good evening, everyone. I am honored and thrilled to be here tonight to celebrate those whose exemplary talents and accomplishments have secured a place in the Dance Music Hall of Fame. You all are the pioneers that have given the world musical treasures that have and will live on for generations. In the early 90s, I had the privilege of being selected to become the new lead singer of the legendary group Chic by two very unique and gifted musical geniuses, Nile Rodgers and the late, great Bernard Edwards. And as their rhythm and bass changed the face of music in the 70s, their gift to me changed my career in the 90s and for all time. I am here tonight to recognize and pay tribute to the greats that have come before me and the greats who have passed on, leaving us with beautiful music, magical memories, and legendary verses and hooks that the rest of us strive to achieve. In April 2006 marks the 10th anniversary of Bernard's passing. We feel his energy all over the stage whenever we're performing, as we currently carry out the Chic legacy. Also remembering Sylvester, Maurice and Andy Gibb, Rick James, Tony Thompson, and the very Luther Vandross, who also was one of the original voices of Chic. Bernard Edwards, a great father, bassist, singer, songwriter, producer, and the co-creator of Chic. I have the very special honor of dedicating this song to our dance legends and my friend and mentor, Mr. Bernard Edwards. We love you and we miss you, even while you're gone.
Yeah, they say time flies by when you're having fun. It seems like only yesterday our friendship was begun. But tomorrow things are different. You believe in I'll still be here. So I hope you know I love you. love you even while you're gone. I try to imagine how it's going to be. Will you still know my name tomorrow? In your eyes, when will I see? But in spite of all these questions, there is one thing I know for sure. It's till the end, I love you. Love you even while you're gone. So I memorize your smile and the sound of your laughter, and it's safe in my heart for just one more time. When you feel my heartbeat, saying you'll always be mine, I'll be there when you awaken, and each night before you sleep, till the end, I love you. Love you even while you're gone. I'll be whispering, I love you. Love you even while you're.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome one of the original voices of Chic, Mr. Fonzie Thornton, and the newest voice of Chic, Miss Jessica Wagner.
One, two, three.
Come on. This is for you, Nile.
Come on, now, this is for you.
Come on, come on, come on.
Everybody, everybody.
Come on. Here we go.
Dance, 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 dance. Keep on dancing. Dance, 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 dance. Just dancing to the beat.
Gonna get down.
Come on,
I'll get down some more. Rumba, El Tango, Latin hustle, tune.
Yowza, yowza, yowza. I wanna boogie with you.
Bye.
said, come on, come on, come on, come on. Dance, 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 dance. Come on, you sing it, say it, dance. I can't hear you. Dance, dance, dance. Come on now. Come on, come on, come on. Dance. Here we go. Dance, dance, dance. Here we go. Oh, free girl. You're free, sis, chic. Free girl. Oh, free girl. You're free.
Please. never has it that it's getting late. Time marches on, just can't wait. The clock keeps turning, why hesitate? You silly fool, you can't change your fate. Let's cut the rug, a little jive and gentle work. We want the best, we won't settle for less. Don't be a drag, participate. Clamps on the hatch, yeah.
One more time, the original Fonzie Thornton and Miss Jessica Wagner for you, Nile.
Miss Silver Logan Sharp, y'all. Mr. Nile Rodgers.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Nile.
Mackerel, what the hell was that? I'm a little concerned. If you weren't up or you didn't move your legs, I suggest those of you who just sat around, you better get to AMCO tomorrow for a lube. I mean, how the hell anybody can sit? And this band, Ray Chu and this band! Why don't you let the guys go backstage for a transfusion for a few moments? I mean, how do you... You guys are burning up. You must be 190 degrees, Ray. Ladies and gentlemen, please, one thing, very important. We're all here for not only to have a great time and to honor dance music and the people that make dance music, but we're here to honor the human race. So don't forget, we have a silent auction where the money goes to getting these kids to become aware of HIV and AIDS. As I told you before, we have to do it. Now, it's only open till 10 o'clock, which means 1 minute. 1 minute. So lock down amazing DJs and remixes for a steal and doing it for a great cause, and it is tax deductible. All right, let's get to work here to present the next award. Catch your breath a little bit. Original vocalist once again coming out from Chic, Mr. Fonzie Thornton. Come on out, Fonz. Accompanied by Silver Logan Sharp and beautiful Wild G. Jessica Wagner.
How's everybody out there? Boy, hey.
Say, ain't no party like a disco. I'm sorry, I'm lost my head for a minute there. Those of us who were around in the late 70s have lasting memories from early days of dance music and of such good times. The next song being inducted this evening is significant not only because it commemorated those good times, but also because of its influence on music today.
That's right. Good Times by Chic, which I am proud to say I sang on, was not only a smash hit breaking out of the clubs, but its Bernard Edwards bass line went on to become the basis of multi-platinum hits, Another One Bites the Dust by Queen and Rapper's Delight by Sugar Hill Gang.
In rap battles on street corners and auditoriums for the next 20 years, it was this song, more than any other, that MCs would use to flex their skills. If there is a missing link that proves that hip-hop is the legitimate child of dance music, Good Times is the DNA that removes all doubt.
To accept the award for the second record being inducted, Good Times, please welcome and give a big happy birthday welcome to
Nile Rodgers of Chic,
my boy. What's up, bro?
Happy birthday.
All right, Jess. All right, I'm going to try and be a lot quicker than Francois. But it would be impossible for me to take this award whenever they give it to me without acknowledging all of the people who make Chic happen. In the very beginning, Bernard and I were just two guys trying to make it happen. And, you know, every time I read something about Chic, they never mention Ashford and Simpson's brother, Jimmy Simpson. Not only did my buddy Robert Drake, no, seriously, not only did my buddy Robert Drake break our first record at the Night Owl, but Jimmy Simpson, I just wanted to get that in before I talk about Good Times. Everybody in Chic, you know, from Bernard Edwards, Tony Thompson, Lucy Martin, Alpha Anderson, Norma Jean Wright, the whole crew, Rob Sabino, Jesus Christ, me, I play guitar, Raymond Jones, the whole crew, Diva Gray, everybody, you know, I'm so sorry, I don't want to spend a whole bunch of time, but it's really important to me that you guys know what it's all about. When we first came up with the record Good Times, everybody kept telling us that dance music was dead. I don't know if you guys remember the whole disco sucks thing, but when Good Times came out, it was number two for a very long time. The proudest moment of my life, people always ask me, hey, Nile, what's the most important thing? It was Good Times staying at number two while another one, no, I'm sorry, while My Sharona was number one and everybody in the world kept saying disco was dead. Anyway, I just want to thank you guys for honoring Chic and Good Times. Peace. Thank you. This is for Bernard Edwards. Thank you.
Congratulations, Nile. Wonderful. Congratulations to you. Ladies and gentlemen, our next DJ will be inducted by the founder for the record, the oldest record pool in the world, my cousin Judy, Judy Weinstein, and a partner in Def Mix Productions, and superstar DJ and superstar model. Didn't we see his picture on a bus a couple of years ago. I think I saw his face. That's where I recognized him. Ladies and gentlemen, here's that guy, David Morales and Judy.
Hello.
Hello.
It's really good to be here, and it's also good to know that all of the DJs that are being inducted into the Hall of Fame belong to the record pool, and that makes me very proud indeed, including him. But we're here to celebrate somebody else's life. He's known as the godfather of house. Frankie Knuckles began. Hi, Frankie. Frankie Knuckles began DJing in the early 70s while he was still a teenager. In 1977, he moved to Chicago, putting together mega mixes of old disco hits with new drum machine. He put together his music, enough with this. And he played at a club called The Warehouse.
In 1983, Frankie opened his own club in Chicago called The Power Plant. Knuckles introduced the sound to many of the Southside producers who made waves during the 1980s that were all part of the house scene. People like Marshall Jefferson, Larry Heard, Adonis, Steve Silk Hurley, and many others. After more than 15 years of spinning vinyl, Frankie Knuckles began recording as well.
Just as Chicago House began spreading worldwide, in 1986, or really 87, Frankie came back to New York. He joined David and I at Def Mix Productions. Thank you very much. And soon brought in Satoshi Tamier, another one of our great guys. And together, they recorded and they remixed some of the biggest stars of the 80s and 90s. Michael Jackson, Diana Ross, Inner City, En Vogue, Frankie Knuckles, David Morales, Satoshi, everyone.
He put his own album out through Virgin and had a big club hit called The Whistle Song in 1991.
Yeah.
Frankie still plays around the world to many enormous audiences. Frankie Knuckles, we are proud to induct you into the Dance Music Hall of Fame.
How are you?
Please step up.
Sing the lyrics to the whistle song. Frankie Knuckles.
Ladies and gentlemen, Frankie Knuckles.
It's official. I'm for real. I've been working all my life to get right here amongst all these people whose records I have played for so long and who've inspired me so much. And now to be friends with you, not just inspirations, but to be friends with so many of you. Thank you so, so much for this. I tell you, when I got the first phone call about this, I kept thinking that there were so many other people that deserved this so much more than I do. And a lot of them are not here anymore, but I will carry this for them, and I'll carry you the love and the support that you've all given me all these years. Thank you very much.
I asked Frankie to do this for me. He and I meet every once in a while at our favorite restaurant together. Ever since I've known you, first of all, as soon as I found out his name was Frankie Knuckles, I don't screw with him. No matter what he wants, I will do anything. Can you tell me, I'm sure everybody knows, but one guy in the room, where did the Frankie Knuckles came from when your real name was Horowitz or something?
No, I was born with this name.
Is that true?
Yeah, absolutely.
You didn't go after a producer and give him a knuckle sandwich, nothing?
Well, there was a couple of times I wanted to, but.
How about a nice round of applause for a great performer?
Thank you.
All right, at this time, we'd like to present a special induction and an award that is given to the non-performer category, ladies and gentlemen. It goes to somebody who had a significant impact on the history of dance music, but was not a DJ, was not an artist, was not a remixer or producer. And to present this special award, my friends, please give a warm welcome to Pat Monaco Sr., who's Vice President of Sales for Universal Motown Group. Cousin Pat.
Well, holy crap, I just got introduced by Cousin Brucie. That is unbelievable. If my father were alive, I would have something to really be proud of. Anyway, few people in the dance music industry are as beloved as this year's recipient of the Dance Music Hall of Fame Lifetime Achievement Award. I've known this man for over 34 years. And in fact, one of the projects I worked with him on, we got on WABC on Cousin Brucie's station called The Bombers by doing store reports and sending free singles out to stores so that when ABC called, they would list The Bombers as one of his records. And it was this man's record. He released the first commercial 12-inch on SEPTA Records in 1975. He founded the label West End Records, the home of some of dance music's classic artists such as Tana Gardner, Karen Young, and the Peach Boys, just to name a few. He also financed the legendary dance club, the Paradise Garage. Yes, the Paradise Garage. There was also a book written about his life called My Life and the Paradise Garage, Keep On Dancing. Throughout almost five decades of his career, his passionate commitment to the music industry has only been matched by his generosity, his dedication, and his never-ending fight against AIDS. Now, please welcome my friend and, yes, my mentor. I've known this man for 35 years. Our 2005 Dance Music Hall of Fame Lifetime Achievement Award, Mel Cheren.
You have no idea how proud I am of Pat Monaco, one of my kids from back in the day. And there was a lot, Frankie and all the others that are inducted tonight. Thank you for this great honor, because it's quite a wonderful feeling to be recognized by my peers in the industry. I would like to congratulate my fellow inductees. Each and every one of you has played a significant role in making music from back in the day danceable R&B, as I call it, so memorable. I have been truly blessed to be part of an industry that I have loved for over 45 years, and even after this time, I have never lost my passion for the music. I would appreciate it if you would please refer to my corrected bio that's been inserted into your program. There were some errors and omissions, and in one of the printings in the program. And since I was on an advisory committee and I knew everyone was so busy doing more important things, I just took it upon myself to make a corrected copy and have it placed in there for your chance to read it. My commitment to but one of the most important things is my commitment about fighting AIDS. And the beneficiary of tonight, for tonight, is LifeBeat. My foundation, 24 Hours for Life, was a fiscal sponsor for LifeBeat. And LifeBeat is a fiscal sponsor for Dance Music Hall of Fame. I've been a member of the board of directors of LifeBeat since its inception, 1992. I hope that I can count on all of you to support this important music industry organization as we continue to face the challenge of AIDS in the years ahead. I'm very proud of our West End Records legacy, and I'm grateful for finding someone to whom I can pass the torch. Kevin Hedge, my friend, my business partner, and president of West End Records and Garage Records. Kevin is also a talented writer, producer, DJ, and half of the soulful and prolific group Blaze. We will be celebrating our 30th anniversary in 2006. Time does fly when you're having a great time. I truly believe it's because of my life in the music business that even though, according to my birth certificate, I'm 72, but up here, I still feel 27. Thank you. I promise my friends in the dance community that I won't give up until we establish a permanent dance music museum here in New York, where it all started. But I can't do this alone. I need all your help. Again, thanks again for this wonderful honor, which I dedicate to two people, Michael Brody and Larry Levan. Thank you.
My cousin Mel, I just like what you just said a few moments ago, that you will not stop until you help establish a museum to recognize the talents of everybody involved in dance music. May I offer you my help and my energy.
You heard him.
I will
Thank
be very
you.
Happy to get Thank involved with this. But it stays in New York.
Absolutely.
Not in Cleveland. Right. In New York.
They got okay. their thing. We got ours. Yep. Hey, thank Please you very much. I appreciate it. You bet. I'm going to get your number.
Thank you. You got it. Absolutely. All right. That's a promise I made in public, and I was very, very happy to get involved with that.